a far-right racist attack. That is how Germany's Chancellor Angela Merkel described the killing of 9 people in 2 shootings in the western town of Hanau. She called racism a poison and said the German government would oppose with all its powers those who sought to divide the country and its citizens. The suspect, a 43-year-old German man. He has been named by local media as Tobias Orr. He was found dead in his home. Police also found another body there, which they've now confirmed is the suspect's 72-year-old mother. Hanau is a large town. It's about 25 kilometres east of the city of Frankfurt. And at about 10 p.m. local time on Wednesday night, the gunman opened fire at 2 shisha bars. First, at the midnight shisha bar, before moving across to the Arena Bar and Cafe in the Kesselstadt neighbourhood, where he continued his attack. Detectives believe nobody else was involved. Here's Chancellor Merkel speaking moments ago.
Doch weist derzeit vieles darauf hin.
A lot of evidence points towards that the perpetrator acted out of far-right and racist motives that stemmed from a hatred towards people with different heritage, different beliefs, or a different look to him. Racism is a poison, hatred is a poison, and this poison exists in our society and is responsible for far too many crimes.
Und es ist schuld an schon viel zu vielen Verbrechen.
Chancellor Merkel there. Well, let's hear a little bit more about the situation as it unfolded during the night from the BBC's Martin Newman.
The immediate aftermath. Police and ambulances descend on the centre of this small town in the middle of the night. Moments earlier, gunmen targeted a shisha bar in the town centre, a traditional Middle Eastern establishment for smoking flavoured tobacco.
I heard a loud shooting. Bang, bang, bang. 5 seconds later, everybody, the person run, scream and much panic.
3 people were killed, many more were wounded.
I got a call from a colleague that there had been a shooting attack here at the kiosk, so I came straight here. Then I heard my father was affected and my little brother. They run the kiosk. But then I saw them both. They were horrified and they were crying and everything. Everyone was shocked.
The gunman then fled the scene. There's a heavily armed police presence and an understandable feeling of fear amongst residents, with authorities urging anyone who has any information about the attack to come forward. Marta Newman, BBC News.
Thanks to Marta. We're going to be hearing more from the BBC security correspondent Frank Gardner a little later on the programme. But let me turn now to Mike Wendling from BBC Trending, who's here with me, because part of this story, of course, is playing out online. What are you seeing?
Well, we know that the suspect here left a series of documents and videos online. So we're sort of combing through those right now. Obviously, it's early days. You have to really kind of take all of this with a note of caution. But we heard the chancellor there say that there was a far-right motivation. This is reflected in some of the documents that we've seen online. But what I've been looking at is also a lot of, I guess, paranoid rambling, I suppose you might say, in the documents and in the videos.
And where were the documents?
So they were on a website that's been taken down, but they're now circulating on far-right and extreme message boards. So the internet never forgets. Once that stuff is out there, people find it and they preserve it.
It must be difficult, though, to verify.
It is, but, you know, we have tools here in the BBC and other news organizations that we can you know, sort of look, and it sort of fits the pattern that we've seen in some of these other mass shootings. Again, I really want to be cautious because in some ways the pattern does fit, in other ways it doesn't. So it doesn't appear that this particular suspect was referencing past attacks or had sort of a very well thought out ideology like we've seen in some of these documents before. Again, we're still sort of combing through them now. But I want to just sort of make the point that it doesn't appear that this person tried to tie themselves to a larger movement or group or organization or sort of trend online.
And I suppose this is the social media age that we live in, that we begin to have a picture that obviously, as you talk about, that cannot be confirmed, but almost immediately after an incident because of the amount of people that are adding information or indeed for the information that might be left by the suspect.
There's a trail out there, but it's also important to remember that there's a lot of disinformation that's circulating on those same fringe message boards or mainstream social networks. So, you know, there's rumors and speculation and claims and counterclaims. Obviously, the authorities are going to be looking at this quite closely, and they'll have access to people and to sites and accounts that we don't necessarily have.
And just very briefly, Mike, I mean, how many documents are you talking about?
There were 3 documents and 2 videos that we've seen and verified so far.
Mike Wendling, BBC Trending, thank you so much.